early rhythm and blues love songs of the 50s. And I used to love to hear, some people were too sophisticated for this kind of music, but you know something? I started to say all music is good, that's not true. But this stuff was nice. I used to like to hear the piano go triplets. And then I like the bass singer would come in singing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then that high voice, that tenor, the unit would sing. Oh, I like that kind of carry-on. Listen, not too long ago, not this last album of ours, but the album preceding it, we had an album full of this kind of stuff, and we got lucky and got a Grammy nomination. One of the reasons for the Grammy nomination was the beautiful way Charles Williams sang, and the lovely way my son played the guitar on this thing. And it's one in particular I want to do for you right now. I want to have Charles sing it for you. It's an old song that I wrote myself for Gladys Knight. I wrote it for her years ago. In fact, it was her first big hit record called Every Beat of My Heart. Here's Charles Williams to sing it for all the pretty girls in the audience.
Melancholy force that Afro-American art form called the blues, which began to develop into rhythm and blues. And we looked around, and when we were first stepchildren, the next thing you know, we blew all those other pop artists out of the water, and those who had considered us anathema and a bane suddenly were reaching out to sign us, the big record companies, the big music publishers. And as time went by, rhythm and blues became known as rock and roll, and of course became the folk music of the entire world.